LeBron James. It's that guy.
Oh, yeah.
It's not just not even a whole year after LeBron openly supported the bubble play-in tournament. LeBron is now saying that whoever created the play-in tournament needs to be fired. And that's paraphrasing his words. Because he just went all the way in. Like, he doesn't like it at all.
Right.
So, I mean, before we even give a take on it, let me just explain to y'all if anyone watching doesn't actually know how this whole thing works. In tournament, the East and the Western Conference teams that are ranked 7th through 10th will play a single elimination tournament next week. The 7 and 8 seed, the winner of that game, will get the 7th seed in the playoffs for their respective conference. So they'll get the 7th seed and they'll go on to face the 2 seed in the playoffs. The loser of the 7-8 game will go now and wait on the 9-10 matchup. The 9-10 winner will now play the 7-8 loser. And the winner of that game will get the 8 seed and advance to play the number 1 seed. So I know that sounds like a little bit of French, but if we just give you some perspective of what that looks like. Right now in the Eastern Conference, Boston is 7, Charlotte is 8, the Pacers are 9, and the Wizards are 10. So if the play-in tournament started today, you get Boston versus Charlotte, and you get the Pacers versus the Wizards. So the winner of Boston and Charlotte, which will more than likely be Boston, would go on to get the 7th seed, and they play the Nets in the first round. Then Charlotte would go on to play the winner of the Wizards and the Pacers, which would be my man Russell Westbrook.
Oh, yeah.
Then Charlotte would then play Washington to go and contend for the 8th seed, which the Wizards would win again. So now we get Washington versus Philly. So that's how that whole thing's going to work. It'll be the same thing on both sides. You know, the Western Conference, you'll have Lakers-Warriors if it started today, and you get Grizzlies-Spurs. So the same succession. The winner of that first game gets the 7th seed. Winner of the second game plays as the loser of the first game. It's pretty simple. It's not even that deep. It's 3 games. I don't even know why people are upset about it. So, I mean, do you think that this is a good idea?
Honestly, I do, because, like, when I think about sports, one thing that really draws me to watch any sport is the fact that anything can always happen. And when you look at the Suns last year going 8-0, and, like, everybody was raving, yes, we know they were pretty bad in a regular season. They had 34 wins. They were, like, 14 games below 500. Excuse me. But when you bring in the play-in tournament, it gives all these teams the opportunity that are on the verge. Maybe if they need just a little extra time, maybe just they do need that extra series or that extra game to get in. Because, like, you look at the Warriors right now. They just knocked off the Suns and the
Utah.
There you go. The two teams in the NBA with the best records right now. So, like, that's a prime example of a team who could still be trying to get the chemistry together. Okay, maybe we just need one more shot at it. And it gives those teams that are on the cusp a chance to get in, because you never know once the playoffs start. Like, I want to say, I know you're going to get mad at me for it, but the helmet catch, weren't the Giants like 9-7 that year?
Yeah, they were.
I wish I could have seen his face. Okay, he's like... Yes.
I'm glad I wasn't on screen.
Yeah, they saved you. They spared you. Yeah, they got you enough in the feud, man. But yeah, when you give a team an extra chance, because like I said, anything can happen in sports. And then once you get the shot to run in the playoffs, you could be clicking in. And you're going to have that underdog mentality. Like, we've seen it happen in the NFL. Maybe not so much in the NBA. Like, yeah, it kind of felt like it with Warriors-Raptors, but we know people were hurting that. You know, no Durant. Klay Thompson had hurt himself, you know.
Yeah.
Was Curry even, like, 100% in that?
I think he was fine, but it was just him.
Right. Well, yeah, it was just him, exactly. So, yeah, I think the play-in tournament's a great idea. I mean, give somebody a new shot. We're always looking for new people to crown. You know, we're going to talk about our NBA awards later. So, like, we're always looking for a new champion, a new guy to be that dude. You know, new media spotlight. Oh, he just emerged last year. Like, how do you think Jamal Murray got talked about this year? Because he went off in the bubble, played well with Jokic. Yep. I'm a fan of the play-in tournament. I love to see new faces all the time, so I'm here for it.
Oh, man, I think it's awesome. I definitely would like to piggyback off of what Steph Curry said. I mean, like, there's teams that get hot near the end of the season, exactly. And now they actually have an opportunity to still get in.
Exactly.
So, I mean, the flip side of that, you get teams that are like, okay, we can't win enough games to get in, so then they go into tank mode.
Yeah.
So now you got a bunch of bad games.
Let's just go for a lottery pick.
The product gets bad. You got teams that already have their spot solidified, which they're still doing that now.
Yeah.
They're in. They don't need to win unless they're really jockeying for a space. But those teams right down there in that bottom little quadrant that we have playing in the play-in tournament, now they really got something to shoot for.
Right.
And you've got teams that are in the 11th spot that are busting their asses to try to get in. Because, like, at 11, you could come up one space, you can get in this play-in tournament, and you still got a shot. I mean, there's players that make names for themselves, just like what the Suns did. Like, they won those eight straight. Those actually weren't the play-in games.
Right.
They didn't make the play-in game. They won those eight and got to 34 and was still just a little short.
Literally played the seeding games, knocked it out of the park, and was like, yep, we still don't have a chance. And like you were saying, you get teams late in the season to where, like, they might be a 34-48 record, but they're playing like they're 60-22. You know, like they're playing like they're really hot. So I'm right there with you on a play-in tournament.
Team may have had injuries during the season. Exactly. They may have finally got the chemistry together. Like, there are many reasons why teams get better later in the season. But if they just have fallen too short, then, like, they get no chance.
Right. And it's really like the play-in tournament's almost like, okay, what's your excuse now? We added this new thing into the NBA that a lot of the old heads are going to be on. And, like, I'm not going to say that it was necessary, but I like it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not against it. So, because, you know, the NBA's been so structured, like, you know, you got your teams, you got your games, and then, you know, the really interesting bubble year. So now it's just another aspect we're adding on. There's no excuse now. It's like, if you're on the cusp, if you feel like you got some time, we just gave it to you there. You know, let's see what happens.
Like, everything evolves. I mean, the NBA playoff format, they used to only play five games in the first round. Now they're all seven.
Yep.
The NFL, they added a game to the season. They added a playoff team into the format.
Right.
They evolve these things to make them better. And there's always people who don't agree with it initially, but then it just becomes like, oh, okay, that actually is pretty cool. Now you get this one more team in. There's another playoff game. Now we got these teams that actually have a chance to get in. If this wasn't the case, the Washington Wizards are now playing very good basketball, but at the 10 seed, they wouldn't be sniffing the playoffs. But now they can just hold on to it. They have a legit shot to get in and really make some noise.
Right.
I mean, I wouldn't pick them to beat the Sixers, but they're going to be a problem.
Right. They're not going to be an easy out.
I'd rather see them play them than Charlotte.
Right. Because then you have a team that gives them a run for their money. They still might lose that round, but they're going to have that tread not on the tires when they go into the second round. And then if it's another working up there, it's like, okay, what's your durability like now? And it's going to be another test too, because, like I said, okay, now there's more. How is it really going to sway these teams? Could it be too much for a team that, man, we really feel like we need to, you know, have this break before the playoff starts? Or, nah, man, you're in a play-in game. Let's see if you even deserve to be in the playoffs. No excuse.